Total Consecration to Jesus through Mary. Hello, and welcome, brothers and sisters in Christ. We are family here that will help you pray the Holy Rosary and more. Please subscribe now and click on the bell icon, so that you'll receive all of our new uploads. Today we'll pray and meditate the day 5 of the 33-day method of prayer and meditation, according to Saint Louis de Montfort's Total Consecration to Jesus through Mary. If you haven't watched the previous days, please check them out. We'll add it in the description box below. Purpose: emptying yourself of the spirit of the world. Examine your conscience, pray, practice renouncement of your own will, mortification, purity of heart. This purity is the indispensable condition for contemplating God in heaven, seeing Him on earth, and knowing Him by the light of faith. The first part of the preparation should be employed in casting off the spirit of the world, which is contrary to that of Jesus Christ. The spirit of the world consists essentially in the denial of the supreme dominion of God, a denial which is manifested in practice by sin and disobedience. Thus it is principally opposed to the spirit of Christ, which is also that of Mary. It manifests itself by the concupiscence of the flesh, by the concupiscence of the eyes, and by the pride of life. By disobedience to God's laws and the abuse of created things. Its works are sin in all forms, then all else by which the devil leads to sin, works which bring error and darkness to the mind, and seduction and corruption to the will. Its pomps are the splendor and the charms employed by the devil to render sin alluring in persons, places, and things.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, Amen. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day He rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead.
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Today's reading: Matthew 6 verse 1-5. Giving to the needy. Beware of practicing your righteousness before other people, in order to be seen by them, for then you will have no reward from your Father who is in heaven. Thus, when you give to the needy, sound no trumpet before you, as the hypocrites do in the synagogues and in the streets, that they may be praised by others. Truly, I say to you, they have received their reward. But when you give to the needy, do not let your left hand know what your right hand is doing, so that your giving may be in secret. And your Father who sees in secret will reward you. The Lord's Prayer. And when you pray, you must not be like the hypocrites, for they love to stand and pray in the synagogues and at the street corners, that they may be seen by others. Truly, I say to you, they have received their reward.
The Imitation of Christ, Book 1, Chapter 18. They were poor in earthly things but rich in grace and virtue. Outwardly destitute, inwardly they were full of grace and divine consolation. Strangers to the world, they were close and intimate friends of God. To themselves, they seemed like nothing, and they were despised by the world. But in the eyes of God, they were precious and beloved. They lived in true humility and simple obedience. They walked in charity and patience, making progress daily on the pathway of spiritual life, and obtaining great favor with God. They were given as an example for all religious, and their power to stimulate us to perfection ought to be greater than that of the lukewarm to tempt us to laxity. How great was the fervor of all religious at the beginning of their holy institution! How great their devotion in prayer and their rivalry for virtue! What splendid discipline flourished among them! What great reverence and obedience in all things, under the rule of a superior! The footsteps they left behind still bear witness that they indeed were holy and perfect men who fought bravely and conquered the world. Today, he who is not a transgressor and who can bear patiently the duties which he has taken upon himself is considered great. How lukewarm and negligent we are! We lose our original fervor very quickly, and we even become weary of life from laziness. Do not you, who have seen so many examples of the devout, fall asleep in the pursuit of virtue?
True devotion to the Blessed Virgin. To Mary alone, God gave the keys of the cellars of divine love, and the ability to enter the most sublime and secret ways of perfection, and lead others along them. Mary alone gives to the unfortunate children of unfaithful Eve entry into that earthly paradise where they may walk pleasantly with God and be safely hidden from their enemies. There they can feed without fear of death on the delicious fruit of the tree of life and the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. They can drink copiously the heavenly waters of that beauteous fountain that gushes forth in such abundance, as she is herself the earthly paradise, that virgin and blessed land from which sinful Adam and Eve were expelled. She lets only those whom she chooses to enter her domain in order to make them saints. All the rich among the people, to use an expression of the Holy Spirit as explained by Saint Bernard, all the rich among the people will look pleadingly upon her countenance throughout all ages, and particularly as the world draws to its end. This means that the greatest saints, those richest in grace and virtue, will be the most assiduous in praying to the most blessed Virgin, looking up to her as the perfect model to imitate, and as a powerful helper to assist them.
Veni Creator Spiritus. Come, Holy Spirit, Creator blessed, and in our souls take up thy rest. Come with thy grace and heavenly aid, to fill the hearts which thou hast made. O Comforter, to thee we cry. O heavenly gift of God Most High. O fount of life and fire of love, and sweet anointing from above. Thou in thy sevenfold gifts are known. Thou, finger of God's hand we own. Thou, promise of the Father. Thou who dost the tongue with power imbue. Kindle our sense from above, and make our hearts o'erflow with love. With patience firm and virtue high, the weakness of our flesh supply. Far from us drive the foe we dread, and grant us thy peace instead. So shall we not, with thee for guide, turn from the path of life aside. Oh, may thy grace on us bestow, the Father and the Son to know, and thee, through endless times confessed, of both the eternal Spirit blessed. Now to the Father and the Son, who rose from death, be glory given. With thou, O Holy Comforter, henceforth by all in earth and heaven, amen. Ave Maris Stella. Hail, O Star of the Ocean, God's own Mother blessed, ever sinless Virgin, Gate of Heaven Ly rest. Taking that sweet Ave, which from Gabriel came, peace confirm within us, changing Eve's name, break the sinner's fetters. Make our blindness day. Chase all evils from us. For all blessings pray. Show thyself a mother. May the Word divine, born for us thine infant, hear our prayers through thine Virgin all excelling, mildest of the mild, free from guilt preserve us, meek and undefiled, keep our life all spotless, make our way secure, till we find in Jesus joy forevermore. Praise to God the Father, honor to the Son, in the Holy Spirit be the glory one, Amen.
Magnificat. My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord. My spirit rejoices in God my Savior. For he has looked with favor on his lowly servant. From this day all generations will call me blessed. The Almighty has done great things for me. And holy is his name. He has mercy on those who fear him. In every generation, he has shown the strength of his arm. He has scattered the proud in their conceit. He has cast down the mighty from their thrones, and has lifted up the lowly. He has filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he has sent away empty. He has come to the help of his servant Israel, for he has remembered his promise of mercy, the promise he made to our fathers, to Abraham and his children forever. Act of Contrition. O my God, I am heartily sorry for having offended thee, and I detest all my sins because of thy just punishments, but most of all because they offend thee, my God, who art all good and deserving of all my love. I firmly resolve with the help of thy grace to sin no more, and to avoid the near occasion of sin, Amen.
Miraculous Medal Prayer of Saint Maximilian Kolbe. O Mary, conceived without sin, pray for us who have recourse to thee to you, and for all those who do not have recourse to thee, especially the enemies of the Church, and those recommended to thee, Amen. Act of Reparation to the Immaculate Heart of Mary. O Most Holy Virgin Mother, we listen with grief to the complaints of your Immaculate Heart, surrounded with the thorns placed therein, at every moment by the blasphemies and ingratitude of ungrateful humanity. We are moved by the ardent desire of loving you as our Mother, and of promoting a true devotion to your Immaculate Heart. We, therefore, kneel before you to manifest the sorrow we feel for the grievances that people cause you, and to atone by our prayers and sacrifices for the offenses with which they return your love. Obtain for them and for us the pardon of so many sins. Hasten the conversion of sinners that they may love Jesus and cease to offend the Lord, already so much offended. Turn your eyes of mercy toward us, that we may love God with all our heart on earth, and enjoy him forever in heaven, Amen.
Concluding Prayer. We fly to your patronage, O Holy Mother of God. Despise not our petitions in our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers. O glorious and blessed Virgin, Amen. The angel of the Lord declared unto Mary, and she conceived of the Holy Spirit. Let us pray. O God, who have willed that by the message of an angel, your word should receive flesh from the womb of the Virgin Mary, grant unto your suppliants, that we who believe that she is truly the Mother of God, may be assisted by her intercession before you. Through the same Christ our Lord, Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end, Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, Amen.
Thanks a lot, dear brothers and sisters. We hope that you learn in today's video. May our Mother Mary always be by our side. And let her mercy upon us and of the world. If you enjoyed day 5 of the Total Consecration to Jesus through Mary, we invite you to like it and share this video with others who may want to consecrate themselves one day. And don't forget to subscribe now and click on the bell icon so that you'll receive all of our new uploads. We look forward to praying with you again on the 6th day of the Total Consecration. God willing, we'll see each other again. God bless you all.